are an emergency department physician trained in pediatric advanced life support. You are working in the pediatric emergency department when a mother brings her 6-year-old daughter into the ED. She reports that the child has a history of asthma. The child's breathing is rapid and shallow. You take vital signs and note that the child's heart rate is 124 beats per minute, respiratory rate is 28, and oxygen saturation is 92%. 1. The correct order of assessment for this child is A. Airway, breathing, circulation. B. Airway, circulation, breathing. C. Circulation, airway, breathing. D. Breathing, airway, circulation. Correct answer, A. Airway, breathing, circulation. Most cardiovascular issues leading to cardiac arrest in children begin with respiratory issues. Therefore, the order of assessment must be airway, breathing, and then circulation. 2. Based on your training in PALS, the next intervention for this child should be A. Apply cardiac monitor. B. Administer oxygen. C. Administer nebulized epinephrine. D. Intubate the child. Correct answer, B. Administer oxygen. The oxygen saturation of less than 94% indicates that oxygenation is not optimal. After a few minutes of oxygen, the pulse oximeter indicates that the child's oxygen saturation has increased to 100%. 3. At this point, you should A. Keep the current oxygen setting. B. Remove the oxygen. C. Titrate oxygen administration to maintain an SpO2 between 94 and 99%. D. Intubate the child. Correct answer, C. Titrate oxygen administration to maintain an SpO2 between 94 and 99%. The child is responding to oxygen, but it is not a good idea to keep the oxygen saturation at 100%. You note that the child has expiratory wheezing and a prolonged expiratory phase. Four, you suspect A, lower airway obstruction, B, upper airway obstruction, C, lung tissue disease, D, disordered control of breathing. Correct answer, A, lower airway obstruction. Expiratory wheezing and a prolonged expiratory phase characterize lower airway obstruction. The symptoms and the child's medical history indicate that the diagnosis is most likely an acute exacerbation of her asthma. As you continue to monitor the child, you notice that she is awake but tired. She is a febrile. The cardiac monitor shows this rhythm. 5. You recognize this rhythm as A. Sinus tachycardia, B. Junctional tachycardia, C. Ventricular tachycardia, D. Sinus rhythm. Correct answer, A. Sinus tachycardia. The narrow QRS, less than 0.09 seconds, rules out ventricular tachycardia. There is a P wave for every QRS. The rate is 160 beats per minute. You attach the cannula to continuous waveform capnography and note this waveform. 6. At this point, you would classify this clinical state as A. Normal, B. Bradypnea, C. Monitor requires calibration, D. Bronchospasm. Correct answer, D, bronchospasm. Shark fin appearance on capnography usually indicates bronchospasm. 7. The next intervention appropriate for this child is A. Consider intubation. B. Percussion and postural drainage. C. Nebulizer treatment with albuterol. D. IV epinephrine. Correct answer, C. Nebulizer treatment with albuterol. For a child with asthma, a nebulizer treatment with albuterol and corticosteroids will help to relax pulmonary smooth muscle, decrease inflammation, and open the airways. As you continue to monitor the child, her breathing slows to 8 breaths per minute. Breath sounds diminish, and oxygen saturation decreases to 88%. You look at the cardiac monitor and see this rhythm. 8. You recognize this rhythm as A. Junctional rhythm, B. Sinus rhythm, C. Sinus bradycardia, D. Third degree heart block. Correct answer, C. Sinus bradycardia. This rhythm looks like a sinus rhythm, but with a slower rate, less than 60 per minute, than normal. 9. Your next intervention is to A. Begin BVM and consider intubation. B. Percussion and postural drainage. C. Repeat the nebulizer treatment with albuterol. D. Administer IV epinephrine. Correct answer, A. Begin BVM and consider intubation. You should immediately provide positive pressure ventilation with a bag mask device if not already in place. The child's symptoms would indicate she is moving toward respiratory failure. 10. The signs and symptoms that indicate that the child is moving toward respiratory failure include A. Bradycardia, B. Bradypnea, C. Decreased breath sounds, D. All of the above. Correct answer, D. All of the above. As the child moves from respiratory distress toward respiratory failure, heart rate, respiratory rate, and breath sounds will all decrease. These are ominous signs. You decide to intubate the child using a cuffed tube. 11. The correct size of ETT for this 6-year-old child would be A. 3.5 millimeters, B. 4 millimeters, C. 4.5 millimeters, D. 5.5 millimeters. Correct answer, D. 5.5 millimeters. An easy equation to quickly calculate the estimated size of an ETT is age divided by 4 plus 4. The clinician should always have a size bigger and a size smaller on hand in case the child is larger or smaller than average for age. You successfully intubate the child and use a PPV device to provide ventilation and oxygenation. The child's oxygen saturation increases to 96%. Heart rate has increased, and you initiate an inline nebulized treatment of albuterol while monitoring her waveform capnography. The pediatrician assumes the care of the child.